Okay, so after I recommend to watch Dan's last two previous videos and the last one. What he's seeing is what I'm looking at as well. And I'm already good, so I'm just in two swing positions, as I said, and I still have my Bitcoin and Ethereum and Binance that I bought on the lows of 2020 and 2018, 19. Just have like 20%, and now I just wait patiently until we have a crash. Until there, I'm doing some swing positions or some trades in between. So, looking at trend lines and some coins very fast. So, this is what I'm looking. This is the daily, but we can do it on the monthly. I normally do it on the monthly and on the weekly, especially on the monthly, but then on the daily we can just adjust the trend lines. So trend lines, like this is MANA, and this is the ranges, and these lines are done on the monthly. So very easy to understand market structures and remember the RSI. So when it's bullish or not, and when we are doing bearish divergence and bullish divergence. But anyway, this is the channel, and then we have the areas to try to trade for the swings and the moving averages. Okay, so this is MANA, this is SAND not looking so good, rejecting. It's also a channel, very precise as well. And we can still come to the top, but now we are rejecting the 21. Let's see how we close today. Look at, but we were extremely overbought, so I think we will come back. This also, we have this trend line for the future, plus this top here, and the moving average for swings. So if we close below here, it's very bad. Until there, this is a good base. And remember the RSI. So that's SAND. Forgot CHD. So here we are holding still here, but we can just do a bearish retest here. I'm seeing this range here with the 200s for the future that might hold. And we create a range like in the past, like here, something like this. And we can do something like that in the future. In this range and not coming back to this area, but we don't know. Let's see. Anyway, CHZ, Metaverse, so also in a range. So we have this trend line here. We got the big peak rejection and we closed below here. And now we also have this one that we are rejecting and this one area that we got to buy and the base here. So I think we can be something like here to see if we have enough strength to break up. Are the ranges to buy. If we close below here, we have the lower range. But it's been quite precise on the trend lines as resistance and as a base. And we can just try to do higher lows here to try to close above here. And then we have resistance here, here, and here. Okay, Crow, crypto.com, still strong. But facing resistance. Also a trend line that we work. 1 point, 2 points. The buy was here, very easy stop loss. And now we are trying to do a higher low. If this holds, we can try to push higher and you can leave bids with the stop loss below here. Very easy. And on the RSI still on the positive slope. So it all depends on Bitcoin, but this is very easy also for risk management, Crow. Sushi, big moves up, big moves down, bullish engulfing, trying to do a higher low, so very easy as well. You can leave bids, stop loss below the low, and you can leave bids, or you just wait until we get a reversal candle, maybe on the 4 hours, to try to push higher. Remember, this will be resistance coming from the top. Something like this can happen, and we can still come higher and then back down again, because we are on $4. I don't know this chart, because this is Coinbase. I don't have, but we are oversold, so we can have a bounce and we just consolidate, and this can be a good base with a stop loss below. Will be good if we go above this trend line here to try to push higher. So for now we are looking for a higher low. Matic looking good, still above all-time highs, and we can still look at all-time highs. Last case we have the 200 in this area and do a trend line like here. After we broke out from this one, we push, and now the 100 is holding, and now the 50 might hold, and we are here trying to pass the whole time high. If we close above, we can push higher. So still strong Matic. Let's see the monthly. So more easy with the monthly. So this is the support here that we managed to close above, and we pushed higher. This is the support, trying maybe a higher low here or here, see if we manage to keep the uptrend. And this is the base, so let's see. It's quite volatile. If we got something like this in the future, we can come back down. For now, it's still strong. EOS, need to go to Doge. So goodbye here, still the same trend line, stop loss below here. We can come here to test it again to see if we have enough strength to push higher. And it's an easy one as well. Let's see if this holds. If we close above here, we can come here and to 1 point, 2 points in the future. If Bitcoin breaks down, this is an area of value. I'm seeing the $1 again on EOS, as this big range is from the low to the high, and with this trend line in between. Stellar, so also an easy chart. We broke below. I'm seeing this area here for the future. We're still holding here the 21, we still have the 20, and we are below the 12. So let's see today at after 8 if we come back down. But remember, we have the 50 here and this swing low here again for a triple bottom. If we close below here in the future, if Bitcoin crashes 1 point, 2 points, and this is the trend line for a crash, but until there we can come down here and try to push higher. And this is the top that worked quite well on this trend line, and now we broke below this one that was working as support. So I'm seeing consolidation. Look at the indicators, we still can come down here, so it's a good trade here or in this range for a swing. Doge. So Doge, another one that I think I have this one made on the daily, but remember we had a big buy. So, but we can come something like this after this big buy, we can come down to make a higher low and push higher. So remember, if Bitcoin consolidates, we can come down even until here, try to make a higher low and then push higher. And if we do on the daily, it's a good base. So we have this point, we can also use that one, but as long, but I think with the lows we use this and this, and we can be doing something like we did here, low, go higher, but the 21 pushing the price down, always the price down until we make a double bottom or a higher low, and suddenly move up. So we can range, come here, and this will try to push the price down, even if you push higher to here. And then let's see if this holds, or this trend line holds with a double bottom, or even do a lower high and then maybe try to push higher. So it's an easy range, and for now we are trying to hold this as well. We can use this week here and also this range as support, and we are trying to hold it as before to try to come at least to here, and then let's see if we come down to test this channel, and then we can create a new channel. So, and the channel top is here, very easy, very precise. So I think this is cool. Cardano, making higher lows here to try to come here, but remember we can come down after. But if this is your stop loss, you can make try to get a higher low here to see if, and then you see some and look at the indicators. We can still have a good bounce as long as this holds. And yeah, so that's Cardano. Let me see on the weekly. So we are trying to hold, but we are rejecting the 50. So it's tricky, but we are doing higher lows, but we can come down to these areas. Will depend on Bitcoin as well, but as long as this holds, we can still come here or to the 21. So this is the range. It's more easy on the monthly, more easy to understand. So this is the range of Cardano that now it's, we have the 20. The 21, it's coming to this range as well, but maybe it will start to go flat, but might still come here. And we are still below the 12. And this is the monthly, so if we close below here, we will come back down to these ones. Let's see if this holds. If it doesn't hold for the future, if Bitcoin crashes, after we've been ranging here for a while, this is support. Try to bounce again. Look at this one. This was previous resistance. We broke up. We never tested that support. For me, this is the big swing trade on Cardano in the future. But for now, we still have this. Only if we close below here, we look at here, even here, or even below, depending on what happens with Bitcoin. But this is a really good trend line for the future. Also along with this one, but this can be 2022, 1 year from now. So nobody knows if we still hold here and or even here and go up. Anyway, just be prepared. Shio, so big red one, and we are trying to, as I said, I've been posting, trying to hold this one. So this is better to look on the daily or on the weekly. So 2 points, 1 point, we can come here, and 1 point, 2 points, this is the two trend lines to leave bids. This is the higher low in this area. If Bitcoin comes down, look at all these, you can leave bids to see if this holds and try to see if we push up. So seems like a good chart also. So I think let's see if we hold, do a double bottom here and hold to come to here. But remember, we also have this one, and this is, can be a good train for to leave bids until this area. And remember, higher low until here, or until here, or until here, and we can still come to these 27s. So, but trend line looks like a good place to buy, even if we have weeks. If they close above, then we can push higher. So that's Shio, that's Caralho, this one. So we are trying to do a higher low, descending wedge, buying weak, trying to hold this area. And so let's see if this keeps on holding for a higher low to push higher, and hopefully we break above this one, because this will push the price down as well, and we can consolidate on this range. Something like this, maybe a capitulation and then big move up. So we can take a while, because there's no liquidity on this one, but it's a range, and we can still come below, because this is 1.3. I don't have previous data from this coin, but as long as this holds, it's fine. Let's see if we got some bullish candles to hold. Check the previous patterns, and we can just reject, hold, maybe some capitulation, close above, push higher. Porto, still looking okay, but we are rejecting the 21 and the 20, so careful. We might come back down. Let's see if this holds and this trend line, but we can come down here and even here in the future. And then we have the two euros area. So as I said, I'm still in the swing position, because I bought it here. I bought it on the 618. And I have bids here, and I have bids on the 1 and on the 80 cents of euro. I have some good money waiting for a capitulation, but I'm just accumulating on the way down. and I'm just taking a small profit. Only now I have only 20% because of this, but then I will add on the lows. So dot, so trying to hold this, dot another one. So trend lines, it's like in crypto and everywhere, it's amazing. So look at this, back again, higher lows, stop loss below to see if this holds. Try to take profits on the way up because we can come down to test it again, something like this. And we are facing resistance, but look at RSI, waiting for a swing up. Look at RSI, you can still do something consolidation here for a while and then try to see if this holds. So that's the trend line of dot. If we close below, remember range, range, range. That can start to look tricky, but remember RSI, it's key here to try to push higher to this upper area. Solana holding the 100, so that's an easy one. Stop loss below, but we are rejecting, trying to do higher low to see if we push higher. Stop loss below here. If we don't hold, we have this area and we go for the weekly. Depends on Bitcoin and yeah. So if this doesn't hold, but there, although there's buying weeks to try to push higher again, remember we have the ranges here, this one and this one. This is made on the monthly, I guess. Yeah, so remember one range, range, we are closing below. And we can do a high, lower high, and we can do a trend line coming down. And this can be a range. But remember, we have this week that we are below. And if we close the month below, but still, we are still on the height. So let's see if this range holds. We can come here, here, or who knows, here. I think we can have huge volatility. After all this big move up, we can have big weeks down. So let's see the future, but we have this range, and this range, and this range. Weekly, the 200, the moving average is here to hold this consolidation, and the 12 is trying to hold, to try to push higher with buying weeks here. But I'm seeing this area again. This is the monthly, but on the weekly, remember we also have this one, and we have this one here. Okay, that's it. BNB. Still trying to hold the 21 and the 12 to push higher. We got the breakout very easy here with this candle. When we close above, confirmation, push higher, and now we have the moving averages. And still the same trend line. If we want to use it as support, we have the 50 moving average here going for there. So if Bitcoin consolidates, we can be also on this trend line to see if it holds. Breaks below, we have all this range here with the 50, the 100 and the 89. And this is the range. If we break below this range, remember, we have here, here, and here. And all these areas below for the future for massive crashes, because we have, if this range doesn't hold here, with this week here, which is on the 156, we can bounce here, we can bounce here, but this is the big one on the 40s. If we have something really bad happening and Binance can have big weeks down, or like a week like this, something like this can happen in the future, just to come for the base and then move up like a flash crash. So you can leave bids like fish bottom in this area, but swing trades in these areas or here. Okay, more Ethereum, yeah. Still holding. Big ranges doing done on the monthly. Triple bottom here. This is the support. That's where we came. So as long as this holds, we can still range a little bit. So very precise. If we have a big breakdown, we have this area and the the 200 below. For massive breakdowns like these ones, when we go below the 21 and the 20, like here, and we have a retest, fake out retest, we can come down big time for the future. Until there, this, if this holds, it's fine, and we are doing the breakout from here, which is cool. We can do it, the trend line here, so something like this we can put in yellow to see if this holds. And that's it. Bitcoin coming down a little bit. So ranging, remember we are in between. If I take all these, we are in this big range, but rejecting the 21 and the 20, and we still have the 12 to reject. And we are trying to hold the 50, and if we can come down here, let's see if then we have enough strength to push higher in this range that we are. Remember, we are still around on the 50 here and still green, but if Bitcoin crashes, remember we have also this trend line here that can work as resistance, and we can push higher and then big test here to see if we have a major crash and another red one. And for now we are ranging in this area, very precise as well from this week and from the monthly as well. So on the monthly it's also the week here, and then we have this next range as well, but we are trying to do a higher low on the monthly to push higher. But let's see if we do, if we don't close above these areas here, we can come down to this one and then range, and then in the future big crash. The 100 is here for this trend line that I'm waiting patiently. Maybe the next 2 years I'm waiting here for my investments. Until there, I'll swing trade this area, this area, this area, this area, these moving averages, this area. So always opportunities to do big trades or swing trades and try to make money. All right, so 4 hours, see what we are doing. So we still have the 20 here, but we are breaking below. Let's see if we still manage to close above, but or hold here 50 and try to hold its base here from this support to see if we push higher to come to these areas. But for now, and we didn't touch on the 4 hours the 21 and the 20 on the weekly, and we have the 12 here, and we still have all these areas, so we can be ranging here to try to push to these areas, or we reject from this area. So let's see what we do. Low, higher low, we can do a trend line here as well, something like this. As long as this holds, it's still okay, but let's see if the 20 holds here. Big range from this to there, and we can be, as Dan explained, do something like on the 30k. We can do something like this buy, and this buy is even bigger. Actually, this buying week, it's bigger than this one. But we can go up, come down, even do a low and range, and then try to push higher. So let's see what we do. Just play safe.